the odds for our fight are 7-1. So our fight was a mismatch. How much of a mismatch is this?
What do you think about Canelo being critical of the choice for Leon Brook? He asked about it.
My suggestion to him, instead of talking, is get him in the ring while he's still fighting, while he's still green. You know, if we're fighting nobody, get him in the ring. Anyway, that's the easiest thing to do, to shut him up.
How surprised were you that he decided he went from We'll Fight Next to We'll Fight in 2017 with the team and the trainer? What was your reaction to that?
If you remember after the photo fight, I said this was going to happen. If you remember after the photo fight, you were interviewing me before the press conference and I said, wait till he comes back, watch what he's going to say. And then he's going to change his mind. Okay? Then Oscar will say it's not the right way. Then Oscar will say all kinds of different excuses to keep him from doing what he promised he was going to do. When he calls Gennady into the ring and says he wants to fight him right now, put the gloves on, what does that say? He's a hypocrite.
A good opportunity to fight the whole big show.
What's preventing some of y'all doing the same thing over there like Ward did? Get the 3-fight deal and guarantee the fight will call next year.
Say it again.
What's preventing y'all and Canelo?
The WBC came over to me after the fight.
Guaranteed
the fight. But they're ordering.
Because I'll tell you what happened. Oscar, in that night that you guys, after the fight, that you had that press conference, Oscar is screaming. We're up at the top doing an interview. Oscar is screaming. Where you at, Tom? I want your phone number. I'm going to call you tomorrow, right? Okay. Eric Gomez called Tom the next day. And then Oscar called him on Monday with a short conversation talking about the 17th, September and 17th. There was nothing signed. There was nothing agreed to. There was nothing. So it's not us.
Is anybody here from HBO?
You guys, it will be September 2017.
Yeah, it said 2017.
Anybody here?
I have to ask you because I'm not supposed to know. Are you calling the Kell Black by fighting Kell Brook?
No. No, it's a completely different fight. It's apples and oranges. You're talking about a Kell Brook that's a 135-pounder that got knocked out by a 135-pounder in one round.
So,
140 pounds gets knocked out by another 140-pounder in Danny Garcia. And everybody that fought him after that was hurting him and putting him down. While an undefeated welterweight champion has never fought under 147.
It's being aired next Saturday, July 30th at 10:15 p.m.
A lot of people, what they would say
PT
is that white guy
ringside at the MGM Grand Garden Arena tonight.
Would you see the movie?
Call the Action.
First of all,
be available on HDTV.
That fight was never discussed. Never discussed in a contract. It was talked about in the media. It was talked about how we wanted to go halfway. We never suggested 164. Now, if they suggest it, they have to negotiate it for it to get that point. Now, once we negotiate and put out a contract, then we turn it down, then you can say it. But it was never got to that point. That Dan Raphael wrote an article about 50-50, about weight and everything. 50-50, that wasn't us. That was Dan Raphael doing it on his own. That's a report. I said, you guys saying that we're going to fight him at 160. It's not the point. It has to be negotiated for it to be a fact. It's not a fact that we didn't want to fight him. We wanted to fight him. I think that's a great fight. I think that's a fight that will happen eventually. But I think that it has to be understood that there's two parties. It's not just Andre Ward.
Are you guys terrific fighters?
Are you willing to fight 160? I have to ask you.